Landing pages are great for converting your visitors into subscribers. And if you set them up right, they can bring you more customers to your business and website. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to create a landing page in WordPress and how to optimize it to convert more visitors into customers and leads fast and easy. To get started on our site, we're going to head over to our WordPress dashboard. To quickly create the landing page, we're going to install a plugin called SeedProd. SeedProd is an amazing landing page builder for WordPress. It takes all of the headache out of creating a landing page and just makes it super simple to get started. You can use the free version in the WordPress repository, but to show you exactly how the plugin works, I'm going to use a pro version, and you can get started at seedprod.com. And if you want, you can use our promo code WPBVIP, and you'll get the best discount on SeedProd if you use that. So you can log into your dashboard, go ahead and go to downloads, and you're looking for the download landing page pro. We'll download that locally. While we're here, we'll also scroll down and we can click on copy our license key. Then we can head back over to our WordPress dashboard and we're going to go to plugins, add new, and we want to upload the plugin, choose file, go and find it and install now. You also want to make sure you stick around to activate the plugin as well. Great, once it's activated, we'll go ahead and paste in our license key so we can verify. You'll see an item up here that says we have a valid license key. And then if you ever need to come back, just look on the left and we now have a SeedProd area where we can get started. So let's go to pages so we can create our first landing page. You see right off out of the beginning, you have several to choose from here. Let's scroll all the way down because we want to create a new landing page. I'm going to click add new landing page. And you can immediately start to see several templates to choose from. They're always putting out new templates and it's very particular. You can even filter on if you're doing coming soon or a 404 sales page, webinar page, a lead squeeze page. For this one, we're going to do a simple sales page. So I'm just going to filter down on sales page and then you can go through and look at them and see which one would you want to do. All right, for this one, we're going to create a course sales page. Maybe we're going to create a course on how to start your own site. And let's click save and start editing the page. And now this is the beauty of how this works. First off, you have a beautiful template that you're working off of. Now you can just change out the content to match what you want to say for your course. You can use the images here or you can remove it. And then I'll show you how you can add a new image in. So I'm going to grab a new one, put it in this block. And then we can click on this and now we can either upload our own image or we can use their stock images. I'll use this one. Great. Now you can update the list of items, list of benefits that they're going to get. Great. And then scrolling down, we have a button here, learn how today. You can say something like get started today or start learning today. Maybe we'll do start learning today. And since this is a button, we want to make sure that we send them to a link of probably the where we're collecting either the email or the sale of this. So you can add your link here. In addition to all of the things that are already here, there's all of these standard blocks or standard buttons that you can choose. There's also a lot of advanced items. So you can do even more social profiles, more social proof. You can do something like a star rating. If you have a video explaining exactly what your course is about, then you can bring in the video here when you click on it. When you click on the gear of the block settings here, then you can update the URL here. If it's not YouTube, then you can do custom and then embed the embed code here. So perfect way to add video to your sales page as well. They also have some cool little sections. So if you know that you have a frequently asked, and if you don't already have that on here, you can go through here and it puts this in. It's formatted perfectly for a frequently asked, how you like it. You can also do more calls to action. You can do a hero image at the top. A lot of people like to do that. So there's all these great little sections that you can already put in here. Then the other cool feature is if we go back to design and you come down here, there's global settings. So if you already have a palette of your branded colors, then you can change these here and it will change all of these. If you're not sure what colors you want, you can either choose to have the ones that they already have, or there's also some color palettes that they automatically bring in for you that you can choose and then it'll update everything. Same thing with the fonts. If you have certain fonts that you want to use, just put the fonts in here, do Open Sans for the header, and then you can do something else for the body text. I think Lotto usually is the secondary one for that combination. And then that changes everything globally. You can also add background images here as well. So a really good way to do a full global setting changes. The other cool thing is down here, you can also do revision history. So as you're making more and more and you're saving it, it'll have a revision history that if you want to go back to something or you want to go back to the basics, then you can do that here. And then I like it down here. You can click on the responsive and you'll see what this will look like on mobile device as well. And then once you go through, you can also connect this. You have several items to connect to, including email marketing providers, as well as some others like Zapier or Google Analytics or reCAPTCHA. And then you can go to page settings and make sure that you've set this up properly. So like we're doing start a site and that's the slug. So that's the full website URL that we're going to have. Right now it's in draft mode. And when we're ready, we can click publish. We'll do that momentarily. Then if you wanted to, you can say powered by SeedProd. You can also add an affiliate link if you're an affiliate. If not, you can join their program here. So even with explaining everything to you, you've pretty much created an amazing landing page very quickly. Now that we've created this, let's go ahead and save it and then we can publish it and see it in action. So I'm going to click publish. I'm going to come up here and click save and click publish. And now we can see the live page. And now this is on our site and we're ready to start selling. And then there are some tips that I'm going to share with you on this. First off, a landing page is quite different than say like your homepage. With your homepage, you are competing for attention of the users. And so you have, you're sharing them where to go for the blog. You have different pages that you want them to go to. You're telling them about you. And there are all of these other different areas about on your homepage. With your landing page, you want it to be as restrictive as possible of their attention. So you want to remove things like the menu up here. I'm going to go ahead and remove this menu. I want to remove that whole header area because I don't want them to see that. I want them to go through my page and I want them to only do start learning today. I want them to see why they want to start learning. I want them to see the social proof. Speaking of which, the social proof is the second thing you really want to bring in. You want to bring in things like the affiliations that you have with other industry rights or other websites. Bring those in. Scrolling down, you want to bring in customer testimonials. This is super helpful in social proof. You want to make them know that other people are interested in this. Another thing that you can do is use something like Trust Pulse. With Trust Pulse, this also brings in a little bubble at the bottom as people are buying, and it'll show them who all has recently bought. You see down here, you see that as well. And then the third thing that you can do is now that you've created one of these, which is great, go ahead and create more. There's nothing that says that you have to create just one. In fact, if I'm doing something like start a website, there are multiple people that we, even with WP Beginner, that we talk to. For instance, we talk to the individual publishers, the individual bloggers. We also reach out to small businesses who are growing their website for their business. And then the third one that we usually deal with are WordPress technicians or people who create websites for their clients. So I would create as many as three or more of these landing pages so that I can talk specifically to them. And that's something that you'll want to do as well. Create multiples. And SeedProd makes it super easy to do that. If you see, I can go in here, I can click duplicate, and now I have a copy of this. So then I can go in and say, specifically for WordPress technicians who are creating sites for their clients, and write the content specifically for them. And that will increase your ability to convert even more with your landing pages. And now make sure you watch this video next where I walk you through how to set up and grow your email list on your website. And thanks for watching.